वेलकम टू थर्ड वीडियो ऑफ द लेक्चर। नाउ आई विल स्टार्ट विद द डेफिनेशन ऑफ यूजुअल स्टोकास्टिक ऑर्डर विद सम बिफोर डिफाइनिंग इट वी टेक वन एग्जांपल ऑफ मोटिवेशन। सो लेट एक्स एंड वाई बी टू वीबल रैंडम वेरिएबल्स एंड देयर रेस्पेक्टिव क्यूमुलेटिव डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन फंक्शंस आर गिवन बाय कैपिटल एफ x is equals to 1 minus e to the power minus x square, fyx is equals to 1 minus e to the power minus 2x divided by square root of pi. For all x greater than or equal to 0, that means all these two CDFs are 0 for x less than 0. So, for negative real numbers, both are 0, because we know that people random variable is a non-negative random variable, so its CDF will be 0 for x negative. So I have just written the CDFs for x non-negative values of real numbers. So one can easily verify that if we find the expected value of x and expected value of y, we will get root pi by 2 in both the cases. Okay. So, if you find this and you are getting that root pi by 2, that means if we compare mean, there is no use of that comparison. So, but if we find the probability that x is greater than x and probability that y is greater than x, then we can easily see that this survival probability of x is bigger than the survival probability of y for all those x which are in 0 to 2 by root pi. And if we see these two things, then the inequality will be reversed if x is bigger than 2 by root pi. So, what we are getting here actually? See, if you just focus upon mean, there is no use. Both have same mean. For example, if I consider that x and y are lifetime of something, okay, lifetime of a person or anything. So, if x is lifetime of male and y is lifetime of female, for example, then from here we are getting that both have same average lifetime. But since we have capital Fx and capital Fy, we have more information than this. So, how we can utilize that information? So, you can see that if we focus upon this survival function, then the survival function of x is bigger than survival function of y in initial stages. That means for initial x. So, what does it mean? It means that for initial stage, this x takes large values. Okay. And for after 2 by root pi, x takes small values. See, from the graph, it can understood very easily. See, from the graph, this continuous line represents the survival function of capital X, and this dotted line represents the survival function of capital Y. So, you can see that this survival function of capital X is above the survival function of capital Y in initial stages. That means it takes small values with high probability. Okay? See, it takes small values with high probability, and after this 2 by root pi, y takes large values with high probability. So, if we are interested, for example, if we are buying something and x and y represent the lifetime of that equipment from two different companies, okay, then you can see that in initial stage, the company one is not better because it has high probability that it takes small values. That means it can fail early. So, if it has a guarantee period, then it's okay. Otherwise, in long term, company one will be good, because initial stages you can replace it by guarantee period, and after that it will not take large values with less probability. So, we have to prefer this dotted line. This will be good in general, although average lifetime is same for both. But we want that in whole real line, one may be better than other. We want that. So, for that we define usual stochastic order. So it says that x, there are two random variables, we denote it, we say that the random variable x is smaller than the random variable y in the usual stochastic order, and we denote it by this x less than stochastic y, we denote it by. And the definition says that if the CDF of x is bigger than the CDF of y for all x, that means CDF of x is always bigger than CDF of y. What does it mean? It means that probability that capital X takes less than or equal to x is bigger than probability that y is less than or equal to x. What it gives actually? It gives, you can see, if x is for example 10. So what we are saying? You are saying that capital X takes values less than 10 with high probability in comparison to capital Y taking values less than 10. So what does it imply? It implies that capital X takes small values with high probabilities. Okay, so if capital X is taking small values with high probability, we should not prefer capital X if it is a lifetime kind of thing. Okay, if it is a risk, then you can prefer it, but otherwise you cannot prefer it. So that we are saying that X is smaller than Y in stochastic order. So it can be interpreted as that X takes smaller values with high probabilities, or you can say that X takes higher values with smaller probabilities, because probability X greater than small x is less than or equal to probability Y greater than small x. This that can be, you can easily get that, because the total probability is 1. And this can be written as in terms of survival function, that survival function of X is smaller than survival function of Y. So what we are saying actually, X is smaller than Y if distribution function of X is bigger than distribution function of Y for all X, or survival function of X is smaller than survival function of Y for all X. So interpretation is very easy. X takes smaller values with high probability, X takes larger values with small probability. That means X is smaller than Y in the usual stochastic order sense. So this is the, we are using CDF and survival function. But all these definitions, most of them can be written as in terms of expected value. Okay. So many times you can get this kind of definition that X is less than Y in stochastic order if expected value of phi X is less than or equal to expected value of phi Y for all increasing functions phi defined from R to R, and we consider that these expectations exist. Okay, we consider that. So if expectations does not exist, we can compare, compare them by using CDF and survival function. But if this thing, so we are actually taking only those functions phi for which expectation exists. Actually, this is the idea. Okay, so this definition actually gives us many things to remember that expected phi x is less than or equal to expected phi y for all increasing functions phi. So this last line will give us the idea why this stochastic order compares the location. I'll discuss that. So I think the definition is clear to all of you. It clearly says that X takes small values with high probability. That means X is less likely to take large values in comparison to Y. So in economics, this is known as first order stochastic dominance. So if you study this, use it in economics, then you can use the term first order stochastic dominance. Now you can note that phi x is equals to x. This is an increasing function. So we can use the last line. Then x is less than or equal to y in stochastic order if and only if expected phi x is less than or equal to expected phi y for all increasing functions phi. So if I take only one increasing function, then we can say that x less than y stochastic implies this. So instead of taking phi x, if I take x, which is an increasing function, we will get expected x less than y in stochastic order implies expected x less than expected y. So that means if you are comparing two random variables with respect to the usual stochastic order, mean has already been compared already. So there is a hidden comparison of the mean. So here you have not compared mean, but If x is smaller than y in the usualist quartic order, mean will be compared. Why? Why? Because, see, what we are saying? We are saying that x takes smaller values with high probability. So, if it takes smaller values with high probability, it will have a smaller average in comparison to y. But it compares more than that. So, if there is a definition, there must be some example and some counterexample. So, we have already seen the counterexample in the case of Weibull distribution, because in Weibull, several functions were crossing each other. So, there is no stochastic order, though no usual stochastic order there. Now, we can have some example of that. So, we take the servile function of two parameter Pareto distribution. So, I define it by, I denote it by PAK. That means the parameters A and K are there, and this is a Pareto distribution, and its survival function is given by f bar x is equals to 1 if x is less than k. See, it is survival function. So, it will be, initially it will be 1, then it will be decreasing to 0. CDF, initially CDF is 0, then it increases to 1. So, this survival function f bar x is 1 if x is less than k, and it is k by x to the power a if x is greater than or equal to k, where k is any real number and but a is a positive number. Now, if we let that we have two Pareto distributions, p a1k1 and p a2k2, that means the parameters of first Pareto is a1k1 and parameters of the second Pareto is a2k2, then you can verify by some mathematical comparison that whenever a2 is smaller than a1 and k1 is smaller than k2, then the survival function of random variable x, that means the Pareto a1k1, will be smaller than the survival function of random variable y. That means x will be smaller than y in the usual stochastic order. Okay, so these are the conditions. If you are choosing two Pareto distributions and this way the their parameters are this way, then they have, they will have stochastic order between them. Okay, so if I take some particular example of a1k1, a2k2, then I have taken this Pareto 5-1 and Pareto 2-2. So you can see that it satisfies the inequalities between a1, a2 and k1, k2. And this is the graph, these are the graphs of survival functions of these. So, you can easily see that continuous line is below and dotted line is above. That means x is smaller than y in usual stochastic order. So, you can see that 4, if we focus upon 4 for example. So, this x will take 4 with very small probability, this y will take 4 with high probability. 6, x takes value 6 with low probability, y takes value 6 with high probability, x takes value for example 1 with high probability and y does not take it. Okay. So, what we are saying? We are saying that x is taking small values with high probability and y is taking large values with high probability. So, ultimately y will, we can say that y is interested in large values. So, x is smaller than y in usual stochastic order. There are some properties, why we call them order actually. So, the usual stochastic order is actually reflexive, transitive and antisymmetric. That is, x is smaller than x in stochastic order, because f bar x is equals to f bar x. So, that can be done. So, it is reflexive. X is smaller than y and y is smaller than z. That means, if f bar x is less than f bar y and f bar y is less than f bar z, that means f bar x is less than f bar z. So, this is a transitive order. And if x is less than y in and y is less than x, that means both distributions will same. So, x and y will have same distribution. So, that property is known as antisymmetric. So, see, the stochastic orders, you can see from if I take the class of all distributions, if I take a class of all distributions, then there exist two distributions in which stochastic order exists, and there exist two distributions in which stochastic order does not exist. That means we can have two distributions with stochastic ordering, and we can have two distributions without any usual stochastic ordering. For example, Weibull. In Weibull case, we do not have usual stochastic order. In Pareto case, for some conditions, it has stochastic orders. So that means ordering is not complete. It is not saying that every two distribution functions will be compared with respect to usual stochastic order. That means one will be smaller than the other. That we are not saying. So the order is not complete. That's why we call it partial orders. So almost all the stochastic orders are actually partial orders. Okay, they are not complete orders. So this is the property. So most of the orders will follow reflexive and transitive property. Antisymmetric may not be followed by many stochastic orders. Now we want to have some characterizations. Characterizations means some equivalent conditions to find the stochastic orders, because you may be interested in finding the stochastic orders. So if you compare the quantile functions instead of survival function, instead of CDF, if you compare the quantile functions, and if the quantile function of x is smaller than the quantile function of y for every p, then x will be smaller than y in stochastic order. That can also be given. And if x is smaller than y in stochastic order, if and only if there exist x hat and y hat, that means two other random variables on the same probability space, such that x hat and x have same distribution, y hat and y have same distribution, and probability that x hat is always is smaller than y hat with probability 1. So where we use this theorem can be used in simulation. See, if x is from exponential, y is from some exponential, some other exponential, you generate data using simulation. So that generated data, you can say that x hat and y hat. Okay. So what we are saying, that x hat is actually generated from some first distribution, y hat is generated from second distribution using simulation. So they will have same distribution. But if all the first, all the generated data, that means whatever you have generated, if your generated data has this kind of probability, that means x hat takes smaller values than y hat with the probability 1, then we can say that they have stochastic ordering, usual stochastic ordering. So this theorem is actually can be used for data validation, that whether our data follows this usual stochastic ordering or not, with the help of simulation. Preservation properties, this is also important. Preservation means when there is an ordering and it preserves some structure. So for example, it says that x preservation under the increasing transformations. Okay, so it says that if x is smaller than y in stochastic order, usual stochastic order, I will not say repeatedly usual stochastic order. If I say stochastic order, that means I am saying usual stochastic order. So if x is smaller than y in st, then if and only phi x is smaller than phi y in stochastic order for all real valued increasing functions phi. What does it mean? See, for example, if x, if you want to know whether e to the power x, and you want to compare e to the power x and e to the power y with respect to usual stochastic order. So since we know that e to the power x is an increasing function, instead of comparing e to the power x and e to the power y, we will compare x and y. That will be okay. So this theorem says that. Now, for example, if x represent the lifetime of machine 1, y represent the lifetime of machine 2. So we are saying that lifetime of machine 1 is smaller than lifetime of machine 2 with respect to stochastic order. If phi x represent the benefit from machine 1, so you can understand this, if lifetime increases, benefit increases, if I assume this, okay? So that means phi is an increasing function. So if lifetime of machine 1 is smaller than lifetime of machine 2, then benefit from machine 1 will be smaller than the benefit of benefit from machine 2 with respect to usual stochastic order. So this theorem has this kind of application. Now preservation under convergence, since we are a statistician, we know that there are lots of convergence in random sequence. So I am just focusing upon the convergence in law, that means the convergence in distribution. So if we have two sequences x and y n of random variables such that our first sequence converges to x in distribution and second sequence y n converges to y. Now our question is this: if every corresponding element of the first sequence is smaller than the corresponding element of the second sequence, that means xn is smaller than yn in usual stochastic order for each n, and xn converges to x and yn converges to x. So this limiting distributions, whether they will have same ordering or not, that is the question. So this theorem says that then x is less than y in usual stochastic order. That means this stochastic ordering will be preserved under convergence. Okay. So you can see that if there are two distributions and the limiting distributions are normal, then those normal distribution will have same comparison with respect to this usual stochastic order. Now there is one more preservation under mixtures. So all of you know about mixtures. So I will explain this mathematical theorem with one example. So suppose here capital theta 1, okay, capital theta 1 is actually representing the drivers, yeah, types of drivers in one city, call it Kanpur, and theta 2 represents types of driver in Lucknow, for example. So types of driver means good drivers, bad drivers, and average drivers, okay, and theta 2 same, good, bad, average. So that means we have two environment, okay. Now what it says that x1 theta fix, when you fix theta, that means good driver, bad driver, or average driver. So there is a claim from that driver x1 theta, and there is a claim from that driver x2 theta, which is from Lucknow and which is from Kanpur. So be two families of random variables, and theta 1, theta 2 random variables common support, I have told you. If x1 theta is less than x2 theta, that means for each kind of driver, that means for bad driver, claim from Kanpur is smaller than the claims from Lucknow for the good driver. For the bad driver, claims from Kanpur is smaller than claims from Lucknow. For average driver, the same thing. So it says x1 theta is smaller than x2 theta for every theta. Remember that theta represents the type of the driver. And what we say, theta 1 is less than theta 2, that means drivers also have this kind of ordering. And then there is an expected value of phi x1 theta. That means if x1 theta increases, phi increases, then expected value of that on an average. That means if you are saying that claim increases, then there is some increasing function, okay. So that kind of thing. So if these two functions, any one of them or both, are increasing for all values, real valued increasing function, then we say that their mixture will have the same distribution. That means if I choose, see, most of you know that about the mixture. If I choose a driver at random, or if I choose a claim at random, so that claim may belong to bad driver, may belong to good driver, may belong to average driver. So we are saying that a claim chosen at random will be smaller than a claim chosen at random from Lucknow. A claim chosen at random from the Kanpur will be smaller than a claim chosen at random from Lucknow. If corresponding claims, see x1 theta is claim from the bad driver, okay, claim from the good driver, claim from the average driver. So if individual groups have this order, then their whole mixing will have the same ordering. Okay, so this is the preservation under mixtures. So there are many many applications of this, there are many properties of this. So one more property, one more preservation property, which is preservation under convolution. I stop here with explaining this. Then in next lecture we will see empirical validation of this stochastic order. So let x1 x2 xn and y1 y2 yn be two sets of independent random variables. Okay, that means now we have x1 x2 xn y1 y2 yn, then they are independent. Xi is smaller than yn in stochastic order, and if we add them, that means if we find the x1 plus x2 plus xn and if we find y1 plus y2 plus yn, whether this stochastic ordering will be preserved or not. So this theorem says stochastic ordering will be preserved. Summation xi will be smaller than summation yi in usual stochastic order. You can have examples, you can have applications of these theorems in your research area or whatever area in which you are interested. So I stop here. We will meet in fourth video to discuss more about usual stochastic orders and other orders.